Testing of polymer and fine slurry at various stages is necessary to operate the polymer and WRP plants successfully and efficiently. Weekly testing should be sufficient most of the time to develop an understanding of plant performance. Successful sampling starts with safety. This includes hard hat, safety glasses, reflective safety vest or jacket, steel toe boots, radio, lock and key. Equipment needed to collect sample. 4 labeled containers capable of holding over 6 pints of liquid. Number 1, mix tank. Number 2, thickener. Number 3, thickener feed. Number 4, WRP feed. Transport box to secure containers after collecting sample. Sample bag and permanent marker. Latex sampling gloves. Camera phone with auto time and date stamps. Please familiarize yourself with the polymer JSA available at the warehouse. Before driving into the quarry to begin sampling, verify headlights are on and check in at the quarry office. If you have not received site-specific training, request it immediately. Sample collection process. Sample polymer from the feed tank in blending room. Sample the diluted polymer at the point of injection into the thickener tank. Sample fine slurry that is fed into the thickener tank. Sample WRP feed below the thickener tank. Collect filter cake from the WRP plant. Sample number 1. Park in front of the blending room. Apply parking brake and wheel chalk as required by MSHA. Watch your step. The walkway has pipe obstruction. Place number 1 mix tank container in front of the discharge tube and pull valve handle. Fill half of the container with blended polymer. Return the sample container to the transport box in the back of the truck. Proceed to the dry polymer feed room and take a picture of the feed rate indicator located at the bottom of feed hopper. Sample number 2. With both containers labeled number 2 thickener and number 3 thickener feed, climb up to the thickener tank catwalk using 3 points of contact at the stairs. Diluted polymer can be sampled from a valve above the tank. Place container labeled number 2 thickener under pipe and pull valve to collect half of the container of diluted polymer. Take a digital picture of both the torque meter and the entire display of the Mount Fury clarifier supervisor. Sample number 3. A tank sampling tube is tied to the railing of the catwalk. Untie tube and transport to slurry feeding chamber nearest to the thickener tank. Hold the rope while dropping the tube to the bottom of the tank and pull tube back out. There is a valve at the bottom of the sampling tube that will release liquid when it is depressed against the bottom of the sampling container. Completely dispense all of the slurry using your finger as necessary. This sample should be labeled number 3 thickener feed. Return sampling tube to its storage location on the catwalk and tie along the edge of the rail. Place containers in transport box. Sample number 4. When sampling the WRP feed, park between the thickener tank and electrical substation 12. Using the remaining container labeled number 4 WRP feed, carefully approach the output pipe below the tank and slightly crack open the valve located near the density gauge. Raise hose to container for a half container worth of polymer treated slurry and be careful not to open the valve more than a slight amount as the pressure of the slurry in this pile is very high. Take a digital picture of the Vega density meter and return container to the transport box. Enter substation 12 and photograph the percent hertz measurement at the 4591 VFD panel. Sample number 5. Request a sample of filter cake from the plant operator. The operator will shut down the belt for you to collect the sample. Record the press number and press section on empty sample bag in addition to the date and time of the sample collection. Turn off the power at the control panel. Be sure to face away from the panel in case of a power surge. Lock out and tag out the panel and verify that the belt is de-energized. return to ground level below the plant, and carefully walk to the belt below the plant. Watch for slipping hazards and unstable terrain. Pull a 2-pound representative sample from the de-energized belt and place in the labeled sample bag. Return to the control room and remove your lock and tag. Re-energize the panel and check with the plant operator to make sure that it is operational. This completes the polymer plant and WRP sampling procedure. Return to the quarry office to sign out.